poet would have called the place Pastoro, as a place out of time, in a world out of balance. The serenity holds a deep, ominous foreboding as a cool, evil smell permeates the silent scape. Some people think they know what it all means. As every breath you take, another moment of life is granted. But what of life and its purpose? Some people wish they were never born. Others kill others out of hatred or madness. And then there is the meek. Whomever watches over this place is lacking in divinity, as well as emotion. Beauty is often mistaken for love and stability. One mistake, and the chain reaction of horrors is unleashed. This is Judgment Day for those of you unlucky enough to have been born this day. And had you known what was to occur, you may wish to never have been born.
Thank you. shit.
Go get it.
I didn't do it purposely. Wait up. Wait up. I didn't do it purposely. Come on.
Got it. Keep looking for the ball.
I think I might have one in the water.
Just keep on looking, okay?
Look a little harder.
Do it. It's lost. What are you gonna do? What'd you find?
I don't know. They're floating around the water. Oh my god.
I've had this before.
Open it.
Yeah, I might open it.
Ah!
What happened?
Something just bit me in the leg.
Holy shit, did she wear it wet?
What if it has rabies or something?
Let's find out where it went.
Where? What was it?
I don't know, but it's in the hole. Wait.
My foot's on the swell. Let's go. You're never gonna find it.
John, I have an idea.
What?
I'm gonna put our stuff in the hole.
Don't open.
Damn, it's too tight.
Don't open it, Ed.
Don't worry. Get away!
What's it?
Wow!
What's that yellow gunk? Don't go near it, you asshole. You know what you're doing?
Yeah, I'm gonna pour on the hole.
Oh. go back there.
I'll be right back in a second. Wait.
Now just get over here, please. Hurry up. All right, hurry up. Just come along. Hurry up. All right, bye. Come on in, Jake. You won't believe this. You just won't believe this. Come on up here. What's the matter, Fred? What's going on? What the hell is that? What's going on here, Fred?
This you won't believe.
I don't believe it. What the hell is...
I was driving down School Drive, and this animal...
Excuse me, here's the airstrips.
Listen to me. This animal, the size of an alligator, comes out of so fast, right in front of my car. I hit the brakes, I hit him, and I cut off an arm. Got caught under the wheel, and he just ran into the bushes. And,
Arm? What, are you kidding?
I got an arm. It just ran. I cut the arm off. The arm is in the kitchen, and...
You got an arm in the kitchen?
I don't know.
Hey, let's take a look at this.
Kitchen?
No. Shit, I don't believe any of this.
What a mess.
Where's the arm? Jake, you can't believe I'm making this up. I mean, look at all the blood. Look at all this mess here.
Fred, who can believe this? An arm that moved by itself?
Jake, we gotta call somebody.
Who?
I don't know. This is unbelievable to me.
Fred, is this all a practical joke?
I'm telling you, man. Why would I lie to you about this? It's just unbelievable. Look at this mess. And not only that, but where did the arm go?
That's too crazy to me.
Jody, I know who we can call. I know somebody who might be able to just... Operator, give me the police. It's an emergency. Hello, police. Yes, I'd like to report an injury and some very, very strange goings on here. I just don't know what to explain. Can you just send somebody over right away? We've got an injured man.
Ah! live from Westcott Swamp in Baldwin, New York. Here, the bodies of two young boys have been found totally mutilated beyond recognition. The slayings definitely have connections with other mass murders which have been taking place in this area recently. And strangely enough, this is right near where the Nassau space rocket crashed into the ocean on its return trip from the planet Venus. Units are still searching the waters for the highly radioactive specimens picked up from the planet's surface.
Put the camera on? The yellow camera? Yeah, I'll pick up Detective Anderson, don't worry. Look, I can only move so fast. Yeah, I'll be there. Yeah. So long.
Spot? This is it. Just look around. Thank you. what exactly are we looking for?
Don't really know.
What I do know is, this is the scene of about 15 murders.
Excuse me, gentlemen, but I suggest you drop your weapons.
Who the hell are you?
Jesus.
Never mind who I am, but I know who you are. Don't try it. I think I'll just take this. And you too. Throw your gun away.
Now move on in that direction.
Over there. Start clearing some dirt away.
What are you talking about?
Just do what I say.
What is this? Some kind of a joke?
No, shut up! No joke.
Now lift it up. There's a hatch. Are we going underground?
Very brilliant, Anderson. Now you and Cameron get going.
Stairs. Don't try anything funny.
I like killing people.
Take a seat over there.
You want to tell us what's going on?
I'm sure both of you
have many questions for me.
Well, I'm going to answer them right now. Both of you were looking for something. Something that's been the cause of many deaths. Well, that cause is right here. Right in this very quadrant. Under my complete control and supervision.
What the hell are you talking about?
I'm talking about a total disorientation of nature, and a major turn in the history of the world.
This place looks like some sort of a laboratory. When was it built?
About 8 months ago, shortly after the crash of the Venus space probe.
You know, I think this situation's getting a little out of proportion.
All right. Come with me. Observe.
Thank you.
after that minor experience, I think you gentlemen might appreciate a good stiff drink.
I should say so. Where in hell did that creature come from?
What you just saw was the killer, and the sudden spread of disease. It was created by radioactive specimens from the probe. I made the spaceship malfunction and crash, so I could obtain the specimens. Somehow, they were lost. But this was the result. I had this place built, and the creature captured.
Expect us to believe that?
Of course not. But how else can you explain the monster?
This is all pretty hard to believe. But what do you plan to do with us? Why did you bring us here?
I need help with my work. You must be my help.
For what? What do you plan to do?
Hold on. What I've discovered, I can either destroy the world or cure every disease and uncover the secrets of immortality.
But how?
That beast in there, it's immortal. It can't die. You can't kill it by shooting it or cutting it up. It can grow a new limb in a day, and all this because of the Venus specimens. But since they're gone, I must work with the weasel of blood.
Weasel?
It's a species of the rodent family.
You said that you could destroy the world.
Yes, by creating multitudes of mutations. Each dismembered limb will grow into a new form of living, breathing life. Here, let me show you. See those domes? Inside each one is the offspring of that monster. All of them to become like its mother.
It seems as though everything is perfect. All this by yourself? Why do you need us?
There's just one problem. The weasel's blood is impure. Rabid. I must synthesize your blood into pure, clean plasma. I believe you've had enough, gentlemen. Good night.
Thank you. will be the last entry in my log. My experiment now nears completion. After this last step, I will live forever.
Thank you. A man like you has got to realize his limitations.
Remains empty, no good will come. thus I'll dwell.